All right, well, welcome. Happy Sunday morning to you. Es feliz domingo por la mañana. Pastors Jose and Patricia, we want to welcome you to New Beginnings Church of the Big Bend. Bienvenidos a la iglesia del nuevo comienzo. So we want to welcome all our NBC family, visitors, and all of those joining us by audio and video. Amen. So praise God. God bless you. Prepare yourselves to receive. God has great things for you. Amen. So don't just come with an attitude of, I'm not going to receive, or just with an attitude of just being closed. Open yourself up. He said he's knocking, but we're not opening. We got to be open for him to bless us. Amen. He's going to knock, and we have to open. Otherwise, he's not going to push his way in. He's not going to force his way in. We need to open up. Amen. So praise God. And God wants to bless you, so let him. He wants to bless you, encourage you, change you, and correct you. He wants to correct us. Amen. We're going to be talking, last week we talked about staying focused in this negative world. We're going to talk a little more about that. But we're going to be talking about staying joyful.
Yeah.
Amen. Because the Bible says, and one of our texts there is Nehemiah 8:10. It says, the joy of the Lord is your strength. Amen. That's the last part of the scripture. And we're going to be looking at it. But his joy is our strength. Amen. So, you know, many people come and they bring you sad news, bad news, all kinds of news to you. Don't let them bring you into their sadness. You bring them into your joy. You bring them into your peace. Amen. And they'll see this by the countenance of your face. You know, when they see your face and you're joyful, they want to know, what is wrong with you? Ain't nothing wrong with me. You're the one that's sad. You're the one that's all discouraged, you know? And they want to know, why are you smiling? Why are you laughing? Why are you so joyful? Then, when they open the doors, then you can tell them, because the joy of the Lord is my strength. He gives me strength every day to do what I need to do. Amen? So he's put you on this mission, and he's equipped you to fulfill this mission. Amen? Woo! Hallelujah, I'm blessed already. So let the word of God change you. Amen? Don't come and stay the same. But be changed. Amen. Lord is not finished with you. He has great plans for you. None of them include defeat. So make yourself available and be open. Amen. So the Bible says we can do all great things, all things through him who strengthens us. Amen. I can do all things through him. Greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. You're a winner. You're a champion. Man, we just finished. Well, today's the last day of the Olympics. But still, there's a lot of winners. Amen. But consider yourself a winner for God. Amen. Jesus, our greatest champion, amen? And you are a champion. That's the way he sees you. We need to start seeing ourselves the way he sees us, amen? He doesn't see us as losers. He sees us as winners, amen? But you have to get in his word and study what the word of God says and find out what the word says. He says, the truth is going to set you free from all these negative things, from all these mindsets, amen? And you know what? When you get the word in you, you're going to be joyful.
Yeah.
And people are going to be mad at you because you're joyful. But I'm going to be joyful. And I'm going to show how strong I am because I'm going to show my joy. I'm going to show my smile. Some of us really need to smile. Amen?
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Give yourself a facelift by smiling once in a while. Give you a spiritual lift. Amen. We need to lift ourselves up in him. Amen.
Yeah.
That's the best high you can get.
Yeah.
Giving yourself a lift in him. Amen.
Yeah.
So prepare yourselves. How to stay joyful. How to be joyful. Amen. Some of us really need to hear this. Amen.
Yeah.
I need to hear it, but some of us really need to hear this. Amen. Because I can tell. Because you always walk around with a frown.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Because you're always down. Because you're always pushing people down instead of lifting them up. Amen. Remember, as Christians, we got to show the love and compassion of God flowing through us.
Amen.
Amen. If it's not flowing through us, you know what I mean? Why even minister to people?
Yeah, that's it.
You know, say, hey, I don't want what you've got. Mm. You're more sad than I am. You're sadder than me.
Mm.
I don't want that. I don't believe in that. Amen. But be a child of God. Amen. Enjoy. And so stay joyful. Stay focused in this negative world. But we're going to stay joyful. Amen. So many distractions out there. But we got to be focused. We got to stay joyful. No matter what, you know. the sad news, the bad news, commercials, advertisement, all these things. People, families, you know, friends always bringing you bad news, sad news. And you need to process this. It goes in, but what you need to do is you need to take the Word of God, and the Bible says, renew your mind with the Word of God. I said, man, I'm not buying into this. This is not what the Word of God says.
That's right.
And you know, when you have the Word of God, you can share with them. This is what the Word of God says. This is what you're standing on, but this is what I'm standing on.
Yes.
I'm standing on what the Word of God says.
Yes.
Amen? And get them all turned around, you know, so they can come into the kingdom. You know, for God so loved the world, it's just that some of them still haven't accepted Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. This is for somebody there, you know. It's time to accept Christ and come into his winning ways. Come into the winning side instead of staying down and out all the time. Amen. So praise God. Grab your sword, soldier of God. And I want you to say it like you mean it. Amen.
Yes.
I've got mine. You got yours.
Yes.
Here we go. Let's make this declaration together. Amen. This is my Bible. I have what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do today. I'll be talking with God. I boldly confess. My mind is alert. My spirit is receptive. And I'll never be the same in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I'm excited. You know what? You make sure you declare it and you say it out. So the enemy can hear it. You want to hear it yourself, but you want the enemy to hear it, you know, because you know what? When you start feeding on the word and speaking the word, the enemy says, submit yourself to God, resist the devil, and he will do what?
Flee.
Flee from you. You know, flee is more than just walk away.
Right.
Flee is like run away. I mean, he is going to get away from you as soon as possible.
Uh-huh.
Amen. So you don't have to just go to Jesus and say, you know, Jesus, do this for me, you know, take care of this for me. He's already done it for you. Now it's time for you to get the word in you so you can start speaking it out for yourself.
Yes, thank
Amen.
You.
Ooh, come on now. Joy. Here's an acronym that you need to write down. I think I shared it with you last week. But joy means Jesus owns you.
Mm.
Amen. When he went to the cross, he paid a debt he didn't owe. And we owe a debt we cannot pay. But Jesus owns us. Amen. We just need to get right with him.
Yeah.
And say, Lord, here I am. I commit myself to you. I submit myself to you. What is it you want me to do?
Yeah.
You're here for a reason. You're here for a mission. And he's the one give you all the information you need. Amen.
Yes.
So praise God.
Yes.
Listen to this. Christians, whether you want to call yourself a Christian or believer, should be the most joyful, happiest people in the world.
Amen.
Now you can write this down, what I'm going to say right here.
Mm.
We're too blessed to be stressed.
Oh, yeah.
We're too blessed to be sad. We're too blessed to be worried. We're too blessed to be disappointed. Amen. If you are any of these things, it's because you're listening to the negative things. You're listening to the bad news instead of the good news, the gospel news. Amen. You're too blessed to be stressed. And you can write this down too. Philippians 4 and 6 says this. King James says, be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God.
Yes.
He's giving us a way out.
Amen.
He says, give it to me. Why do you still carry it?
Mm-hmm.
Why is it that you still have it? He says, be careful for nothing, but in everything, give it to him. Amen.
Amen.
In 1 Peter 5:7 says, in the King James also, says, casting all your care upon him. Why? Because he cares for you.
Mm-hmm.
He knows. He went through all these things, so we don't have to go through these things. Just cast it on him. Give it to him. Lord, I thank you for this new day. I will rejoice and be glad in it. But everything that's coming my way, enemies bringing my way, I just cast it on you.
Yes.
Amen. I just give it all to you. Amen. And I'm going to press through, and I'm going to accomplish what you called me to do.
Amen.
We become Christians. Everything is great. Everything is smooth. Everything is easy.
Uh-huh.
Everything is comfy. We like it that way. But guess what? Our priorities change. The joy and the happiness goes out and the world come back in. We open the world, we open the door to the world.
Mm.
How is this? Because the words we speak.
Mm.
We're speaking the wrong things now. We're not confessing the word anymore. Now we're confessing the sad news, the bad news. You know, we're magnifying the problem instead of magnifying God.
Right,
and we open the door, and the world is going to come right back in.
Oh, yeah.
We invited it in. We opened the door. So be careful of the things we confess, the things we speak. Mm-hmm. Amen? We got to be careful. We don't have to, we don't let the change our priorities. Keep our priorities in order. Amen? Now I know why I need to take them off. The old goes out and the new goes out and the old comes in. Sinful ways, bad habits, friends, stay focused, stay connected. Keep your mind renewed all the time. Not just sometimes, but all the time.
Yeah.
You know, that could be many times a day. Lord, I need to renew. I just renew my mind to the things of God, you know, because you're bombarded on a daily basis by negative people, negative world, negative advertising, and negative everything. So I say, wait a minute, I got to stay focused. I'm running this race. And for me to fulfill this race, I got to stay positive. Amen. Come on. Too many Christians, listen. We're talking believers here. We're talking too many Christians struggling through life. Too many Christians living a defeated life. He made us to be winners, not losers.
That's
amen.
Right.
He made us to win and not to be defeated. Amen.
Right.
We are, well, you need to know this. The enemy, the devil, is a defeated foe. Jesus already defeated him. So why are we letting a defeated foe over us, win over us? Don't let a defeated enemy win over us. Amen. We should be joyful and happy.
Yeah.
We should be shouting victory daily on our way to heaven.
Yeah.
Amen. The Bible says, "This is not my world. This is not my place. This world is not my place. Mm-hmm. Heaven is my home."
Yeah.
Amen. And I'm just passing through. I'm just fulfilling what God wants me to do.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. But you know what? Hey, I'm shouting victory. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lord, for this day. He says in Psalms 118:24 says what?
Yes.
This is the day the Lord has made.
Yes.
I shall rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. So rejoice and be glad in it. I'm shouting victory on my way to heaven. Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
But instead, we are sad, struggling, defeated.
All right now.
And want to quit.
Mm-hmm.
Want to give up. You know how many opportunities Jesus had to quit?
Mm-hmm.
How many opportunities he said he could have told the Father, get me out of here. This ain't worth it. But you know, he prayed.
Yes, he did.
And asked the Father for strength.
Yes.
Asked the Father for what he needed. And the Lord gave him the strength.
Yes.
We need to do the same thing. He showed us. So we can do the same thing. We go to him and say, Jesus, you fulfilled this. You completed this. Show me what I need to do to complete this.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And you know what he'll tell you? He says, go to my word. I already spoke it. It's already written. But you need to do something about it. Don't just go to Jesus and put it back on him. His mission is completed.
Yes, it is.
He wants us to open his word and read his word so that we can complete this mission that he's put us on. Amen.
Yes.
And be aware.
Yes. Thank you.
And of course, our text, Nehemiah 10 in King James says, for the joy of the Lord is your strength.
Yeah.
The easy to read version says it like this. Don't be sad, because the joy of the Lord will make you strong.
Yes.
The joy of the Lord will make you strong.
Mm-hmm.
The joy of the Lord is our strength.
Yes.
So be joyful. Stay joyful. Don't let circumstances, don't let sad news bring you down. Amen. And the Amplified, listen, this is what the Amplified says. This is the Amplified version. It says this. Do not be worried, for the joy of the Lord is your strength and your stronghold.
Yeah.
This is the Amplified. This is, so sometimes it's good to just read some different translations, see what they say.
Mm-hmm.
The Amplified. Do not be worried, for the joy of the Lord is your strength and your stronghold.
Yes.
Man, I need to have some solid roots. And if I'm gonna stand, I'm gonna stand on this stronghold. I'm gonna stand on him. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So start celebrating your life. Be joyful and be happy. Amen. Don't just endure your days. Enjoy your days. Rejoice and be glad in your days. He says, this is the day the Lord has given you. Rejoice and be glad in it. So instead of just enduring your days and putting up with your days and tolerating your days, whoo, that was a hard day. No, it says enjoy your day. Mm-hmm. Amen? Whoo, smile, give your face a lift.
Yes.
And a spiritual lift. Give with Christian friends and enjoy. Get free, laugh, smile. Psalms 34 and 8. I'm going to give you a lot of scriptures so you can write these down. Psalms 34 and 8 says this in a New Living Translation. Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Yes.
Oh, the joys of those who take refuge in Him. Mm-hmm. Man, He's my refuge. He's my stronghold. I'm going to take refuge in Him. Amen. It says taste and see. You know, we're going to have a fellowship afterwards. We got a great meal. And when you eat this meal, you're going to taste. And you're going to say, man, this is good. Yes. Well, this translation says, taste and see that the Lord is good.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
But we got to take it in. Not just, you know, read it and let it go. Mm-hmm. Meditate on it. Amen. Yeah. Now, Psalms 37:4 says this. New King James. Delight. Enjoy yourself also in the Lord. And He shall give you the desires of your heart.
Yes. Amen.
He shall give you the desires of your heart. So, praise God. These are great. Amen.
Yes.
Proverbs 17:22. Let me see. I've got some slides here I want to read at you. Psalms 37:34. Delight yourself in the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart. Amen. Keep going, sir. It says, a cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. Proverbs 17:22. Go to the next one. A joyful heart is good medicine. Amen. And that's what I want to read to you right now. Proverbs 17:22 says, a cheerful, happy, joyful heart is good medicine, but a broken spirit saps a person's strength. Amen.
Yeah.
Isn't this awesome? This is awesome. This is the word of God. Mm-hmm. How do I do this? What do? And so and so says this. Mm-hmm. So and so, or this person says that. Mm-hmm. No, what does the word of God say?
Yeah.
Says a cheerful, happy, joyful heart is good medicine.
Yes.
Amen. But a broken spirit saps a person's strength.
Mm.
So you don't want a broken spirit. You don't want a sad spirit. You want a cheerful, happy, joyful spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Says every morning when you wake up, before you even get out of bed, just encourage yourself and declare out loud. Says, I am going to enjoy this day. Why? Again. Psalm 118:24.
Yes.
This is the day God has given me. And I, and you can put your name on
that.
I, Jose, am going to be rejoice and be glad in it. Be rejoice and be glad in. Yeah, but you don't know what's facing me.
No.
Yeah, you don't know what's coming against me. You don't know what I'm facing.
Mm.
But He does.
Yes, He does.
And I'm going to rejoice now. I'm trusting You. And I have faith. I'm going to walk by faith and not by sight.
Yes.
I'm going to walk by faith and not by fear.
That's right.
Amen. That's from the enemy. I'm going to walk by faith and not by fear. Amen.
Amen.
So declare, you know, hey, I'm going to enjoy this day today. Oh, no, it's Friday. Amen. Oh, no, it's Tuesday. Only times we wake up is when, oh, well, thank God, it's Friday. But every day,
yes.
Thank Him. Say, this is the day. Every day. Tomorrow's going to be this day is the day the Lord has made.
Yes.
I will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen? Come on now.
Amen.
It says, I will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen?
Uh-huh.
Don't worry about circumstances or who's going to do what or what's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
I am counting on Him. Amen?
Yes.
Praise God. John 15:11 says this, I have told you this so that my joy may be in you.
Yes.
And that your joy may be complete.
Oh.
So decide to be joyful and happy and smile right where you are.
Yes.
Right where you are, wherever you happen to be. Anybody remember Paul and Silas?
No, yeah.
They were beaten.
Mm-hmm.
And yet, at the midnight hour,
mm-hmm.
they were way down in the dungeon, you know, in the jail. And at midnight, they started praising God. Saying, well, you don't know what I've been through. You don't know what I'm going through. I can't praise God right now.
No.
Well, you don't know what they went through and what they were reaching for.
Mm-hmm.
And that still, at the midnight hour, they decided to praise God.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what? He heard him.
Yes.
And he shows up.
Yes.
And then some people changes took place. Amen. And here's the good part here. Bloom, blossom, wherever God plants you or wherever He has you. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not just, well, I don't want to be here. I'm so mad and I'm so sad because I don't want to be here.
Yeah.
But Lord, wherever You place me, I will do my best for You.
Amen.
Amen. Decide right now. Lord, I'm doing this under You. Mm-hmm. It's one of my favorite scriptures, Colossians 3:23 mm-hmm. and 24. You know, if you're going to serve God, yeah. do it as unto Him. So we don't have attitudes about, well, they got problems and they didn't like what I did. They didn't thank me. And these people are mean. These people are ugly.
Oh, gosh.
Well, they were ugly to Jesus, too.
Yes.
Amen. So if you're going to decide what to do, decide, Lord, I'm going to do this under You.
Yes.
So if anything happens you don't like, Lord, I'm giving this to You.
Yes.
I'm doing this under You. Come on now.
Yeah, that's right.
So, you know, somebody's always coming back at you and saying, well, you don't know what I've been through.
Yeah.
Well, you don't know what Jesus went through.
That's right.
I mean, what's written in the Bible is just harder in real life of what Jesus went through.
Yes.
Amen. So make a firm decision to enjoy your race on a daily basis.
Yes.
Lord, I'm going to enjoy this mission You've given me. I'm going to enjoy this race. And I'm going to complete my race because I'm looking to You. And You're my stronghold. Amen?
Yes.
Man, praise God. When you really will begin to experience the abundant, joyful life that Jesus died to give you. Remember John 10:10 says, the thief, the enemy, the devil, cometh. He says, but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. Jesus says, I have come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. Amen. This is Jesus. This is our Jesus. And you know, if you're going to live your life abundantly, there's got to be some joy in there.
Yeah.
There's got to be joy involved. Yeah. Praise God. Amen.
Amen.
And, you know, when Jesus gave His life back to the Father, before He gave His life to the Father, He says, Father, forgive them.
Yeah.
That took a lot to say that. You know,
yes.
Well, you don't know what I've been through. Well, look at what Jesus went through. The beatings and all the humiliation He went through. And to be up there in public, you know, without naked, you know. People watching Him. People seeing Him. And still He told the Father, forgive. And He did. And He was joyful about it. He was sad about it. Psalms. Let's read Psalms 100. This is one of my favorites. I want to read it to you from the... from the King James, and then I want to read it to you from the Amplified. But it says, well, let me open your Bibles, Psalms 100.
Okay.
Man, always, this is a great, this is a great, 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 great song.
It's on the screen.
It's on the screen, thank you.
Yes.
What version? Here we go. It says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord all ye lands.
Yes.
Serve the Lord with sadness.
Gladness.
Oh, gladness. Okay. Serve the Lord with gladness.
Uh-huh.
Come before His presence with singing. You know, you don't know sin if you ain't joyful.
No.
If you're not glad, you're not going to sing, okay? Nobody's going to make you sing.
Uh-uh.
How come you're not singing? I'm mad. I'm sad. You know?
Oh, God.
3 says, know ye that the Lord He is God, He is easy. That He is God, is He that made us, and that we ourselves. We are His people and the sheep of His pasture.
Yes.
Enter into His gates with
thanksgiving.
Enter His courts with praise. Be thankful unto Him and bless His name. For the Lord is
good,
His mercy is everlasting, and His truth endureth to all generations. Amen. Let me read it to you from the Amplified. It's a psalm of thanksgiving. It says, shout joyfully to the Lord of all the earth.
Uh-huh.
Serve the Lord with gladness and delight.
Yeah.
Come before His presence with joyful singing.
Yeah.
Know and fully recognize with gratitude that the Lord Himself is God. It is He who made us, not we ourselves. We are His.
Uh-huh.
We are His people and the sheep of his pasture, his, all the hises that you that I said are in capital letters. Amen. And verse 4 says, enter his gates with a song of thanksgiving, and into and his court with praise. Be thankful to him, bless and praise his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy and loving kindness are everlasting. His faithfulness endureth to all generations. Yes. Amen. Man, now, if that don't bless you, we got to get you saved. Amen. If none of this is ruling you, it's time for you to say, Lord, I've sinned against you. I repent. Come in my life, be my Lord and Savior. It's never too late, you know. All it takes is one step in the right direction. All you need to do is do an about face, and you're right there with them. Amen. That's all it takes. It's just one step away. Woo. Hallelujah. Psalm 16:11 says, New King James, you will show me the path of life.
Yeah.
And your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Man. Amen. Nothing sad about these things.
That's right.
You write these down or go over the message again, you know. Philippians 4:4 says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say,
rejoice. Yes.
If you get it the first time, get it the second time. But rejoice, rejoice, rejoice.
Uh-huh.
This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice.
Yes.
He uses this all the time. Rejoice and be glad in him.
Yes.
Amen. 1 Thessalonians 5:16, New German Translation version says, be full of joy all the time.
Yeah.
Rejoice always. That's the New King James. It says, rejoice always. But the New Living Version says this, be full of joy all the time. Not just sometimes, but all the time. 1 Thessalonians 5:16. And of course, this is the reason right here.
Yeah.
John 3:16.
Oh, yeah.
For God so loved the world, I want my people back. So I'm going to sacrifice my son.
Mm.
He says, For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
Everlasting
there we go.
Life.
Thank you, Carmen. Go to the next one. Awesome. Keep going. There we go. This is good. He said, for he himself has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you.
Yeah.
When you feel all alone, when you feel all by yourself,
mm-hmm. You're
not alone. If you're a child of God, God is with you.
Yes.
Amen. You just got to look to him.
Yeah.
Lord, I need you now more than ever.
Yes.
Lord, I need you now more than ever.
Amen.
More than yesterday.
Yes.
More than words can say.
Yes.
I need you now. Man, that's a beautiful song.
Yes, it is.
Still, you know, I need you now.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what? He says, I'm with you. I never leave you nor forsake you.
That's right.
He's always with you. Wherever you happen to be going.
Yeah.
So, don't go there. Praise God. More songs. Psalms 95
mm-hmm.
and 2, New King James. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving,
uh-huh.
and let us shout joyfully to him with psalms.
Yes.
Amen. So, you know, when it's okay for you to go before him and sing and just say, Lord, I just want to say thank you.
Yeah.
With a heart of gratitude, you know.
Yes.
Amen. With an attitude of gratitude and say, thank you, Lord. Thank you. When you don't know what else to say.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what else to, what to say. When you know what?
Mm-hmm.
Say thank you.
Thank you.
Amen. Or I love you. Amen.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Listen to this. People, including believers, Christians, spend most of their time. I'm going to take my time and read these so you can get them. People, or you could say including believers, spend most of their time defeated, beaten, overpowered, overcome, overwhelmed, and crushed.
Oh, wow.
That's just defeated, under defeated, uptight, tensed, anxious, and worried, upset. Under upset is sad, troubled, and full of cares.
Wow.
Amen. You know what? You're not a garbage pail. You're not a garbage dump. You're not a dumpster where the world or anybody can just come and dump all their trash on you. I say, I'm not receiving it. You know, Satan, take it somewhere else. And I'm forgiven. So you can take it somewhere else. You ain't gonna put that on me anymore.
That's right.
Amen. You gotta stand your ground, you know, because he's gonna try to bring it right back to you.
Right.
And you're gonna say, wait a minute, I'm forgiven. So if Jesus has forgiven me, I'm not taking it anymore.
Yes,
so
yes.
Go somewhere else. Yes. I'm not receiving that. It's not for me. Here's overstressed.
Oh boy.
Burdened, overloaded, overstretched, and over. Strained, man, and discouraged. Discouraged means downcast, depressed, dejected, disheartened, and hopeless.
Oh wow!
Oh my God! You know, don't. It says people, including believers, defeated, uptight, upset, overstressed, and discouraged. We shouldn't even be there.
Yeah.
You know, if you're feeling this way, it's time for you to spend some time with the Father.
Yes.
If you have a relationship, you shouldn't even be feeling this way.
That's right.
Because relationship will put a joy, give you joy, give you a smile, amen, and not this. Because of joy and your happiness, smile is based entirely on circumstances. The wrong thing. Wrong job, wrong career, relationship, friends, or habits. Amen. So don't let your circumstances dictate on your joy.
That's right.
Amen. Praise God. Again, 1 Peter 5:7 in the Expanded Bible says this: give all your worries to him. Cast all your anxieties on him, because he cares not to. Psalms 55:22 in the Expanded Bible says, throw your worries, your burdens, that which he has given you, that which he has given you to the Lord, and he will take care of, sustain you. He will never let good or righteous people go down or be moved.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Ooh, my God. Thank you, Lord. Why use your joy when you can cast and give it all to him? Amen. I say, wait a minute. You start meditating on the negative, you start meditating on something wrong, and you're going to bring yourself down.
Yeah.
Instead of saying, wait a minute, that's not for me. I rebuke that. I release that. I don't take that and start meditating on what the Word of God says.
Yeah.
Amen. It's going to lift you up. Say, I'm not going there. Not anymore. You ain't going to have your way with me, Satan, anymore. Stay joyful. Keep your smile. And don't let it go. Keep your spirit, joyful, happiness, and smiling batteries charged up. You know, the batteries in your car, keep it charged up.
Yes.
Amen. For it to run. Anything that uses batteries, you got to keep those batteries going in order for that thing to function. So we need to keep our spiritual, joyful batteries charged all the time. And how is this? Getting in the Word. And having a relationship, spending time with the Father. And those batteries are going to stay charged all the time. Amen. Don't let your batteries down. And this is your responsibility. You have a choice.
Yeah.
Amen. When things come, circumstances come, things come your way, don't let it down. Say, wait a minute. Put the shield up. Say, no, I'm not doing that. So keep your spiritual batteries charged. No frowns, smiles only. Why? We fight a spiritual battle daily. We need to know this. The time we know this. We can fight a spiritual battle daily.
Yeah.
Part-time Christian is no match to a full-time devil.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
If we're fighting a spiritual battle and you're halfway in, guess what? You're already defeated.
Yeah. That's it.
Because the enemy knows what you're confessing, and the enemy knows where to attack. He knows your weakness, because that's all you've been confessing is the problem. Your weakness. Amen. So don't be part-time. Be full-time.
Amen.
You know how the world wants to do only halfway, part-times. We don't do that. We don't want to be part-time Christians.
That's right.
We don't want to be full-time Christians.
Amen.
Amen. Put on the full armor of
yes.
God. Keep on the full armor of
yes.
God, not just part of the armor.
That's
we
right.
want to protect all of us. Amen.
Yes. Yes.
Ephesians 6:12 says this in the Expanded Bible. For our fight, our conflict, our struggle is not against people on earth.
That's right.
Flesh and blood, but against the rulers and authorities of, and the powers for cosmic powers and rulers of this world, darkness, against the spiritual powers of evil in the heavenly world, the realms, the places. So we're fighting against things. If we're not in the spirit, if we're not in the word or using the word, you're already defeated.
Yeah.
But you're going to fight this spiritual battle on a daily basis.
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. How are we doing? Thank you, Lord.
Thank
you. We may continue this next week, but steps of keeping your joy. Here's some steps of how to keep your joy. Joy is a result of knowing whose you are and who you are in Him. When you know who you are and whose you are, you know, that is going to help me know I can keep my joy. I don't have to give it up. You know, if you see somebody with a frown, you don't have to take the frown.
Yeah.
You don't have to copy that.
That's it.
You just keep your joy. And I'm believing that my joy is going to be contagious. And they're going to catch my joy.
Amen.
Amen. And I'm not going to catch what they got.
Yeah.
So, be led by the Spirit. Your joy. Keep your joy by allowing the Holy Spirit to lead and guide us in a way we should go. And I'm going to give you some scripture here. Psalms 37:23 in the Amplified says, the steps of a good and righteous man are directed and established by the Lord.
Yeah.
And he delights in his ways and blesses his path. Amen. So the steps of a good man are ordered of the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. When you're obedient to him, says the steps of a good man are ordered of God.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So my steps are being ordered by him.
Amen.
I'm being faithful. Also in Proverbs 3:5-6 says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not to in thine own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path.
Amen.
Yes. So you don't know which way to go? Here's your GPS right here.
Yeah.
Just tune in to the Holy Spirit. He's going to take you in the right way.
Amen.
Yeah. He's going to direct your steps and what steps to take. Amen. Proverbs 16:9 in the easy to read version says this, people can plan what they want to do, but it is the Lord who guides and directs their steps.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Please continue to direct my steps and guide me in the right way that I should go. Amen.
Yes.
Woo. Hallelujah. You know how many people are crashing, you know, because
crashing and burning.
Too many people complain about how boring life is, including believers. They need to check their priorities. Matthew 6:33 says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. They lost their love for God. They've opened the door for the enemy and other things. Amen. When you're not confessing the word, you're going to confess something, and it's going to be negative.
Yeah.
And you're confessing negative things, and the enemy is going to come in. The world's going to come in.
Yeah.
The negative things are going to come in, and you're going to be back to what it used to be.
Yes.
And you don't have to go there. You can put a stop to it right away.
Yes. Amen.
Get back in relationship with God. Mm-hmm. Life is not boring. Our priorities slip.
Mm-hmm.
Just remember, Jesus first. Jesus first. Matthew 6:33. Jesus first.
Yes.
Life is not boring if we're led by the Holy Spirit. You will lose your joy if you're not willing to get out of the boat or your box or your comfort zone and be led by the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Amen. If he's telling you to do something, it's time you step out of your boat.
Yes.
You know, everybody's coming out of their closets and declaring what they want to be. It's time Christians come out of their closets, you know, and say, well,
I'm a
Christian.
I'm a Christian.
You're going to shock some people when you tell them that. Say, wow, I didn't even know that.
You didn't even show no signs, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Because we don't want to be pretenders, and we don't want to be part-times, you know? We only come in here and jump and shout and holler, you know? And everybody sees you doing all that, but when you leave the four walls here, mm-hmm. you're somebody else.
Yeah.
You know, you're a friend to the world.
Oh, gosh.
And I didn't even know you was a Christian.
Mm.
We got to stop pretending.
Yeah.
Amen. We got to be for real.
Praise God.
Simplify your life. Uncomplicate your life. Don't try to do too much. Satan complicates your life so he can steal, kill, and destroy.
Mm-hmm.
And steal your joy. I got too many things to do. Remember the story? It keeps us so busy to enjoy all God has given you.
Yeah.
Remember Mary and Martha? Mary is enjoying herself. She's ministering to the master.
Uh-huh.
Martha sees all the work that needs to be done. He even tells the master, could you tell her to please come and help? She says, Martha, you're going to have this all forever,
yeah.
you know? But how many times do you have an opportunity to serve the master?
Yes.
Amen. Come on now. Enjoy your relationship with God. Enjoy time with family and friends. Take time to laugh and crack a smile once in a while. Some really need to crack a smile. Take time to enjoy life. When you have God first in your life, guess what? You're going to enjoy life. And it's not just by circumstances. You know, too many people come in church, in our assembly here, and want to be entertained.
Yeah.
And that's not what we're doing. We need to come here and be empowered to
yes.
go and do what God wants us to do.
That's right.
Amen. To be encouraged.
Yeah.
Amen. Say, brother, sister, you know, praise God, you're doing well.
Uh-huh.
Keep doing this, you know. Mm-hmm. Be encouraged. Praise God. Enjoy life. I'll give you one more and then we'll stop here. Pray with boldness. Hebrews 4:16 in the New Living Translation says, so let us come boldly to the throne of our gracious God. Then we will receive his mercy, and we will find grace to help us when we need it most. So be bold and confident in God when you pray. Don't be double-minded when you're asked for his blessings. Just ask for what you need and boldly and in faith. Without wavering, hesitating, or doubting, knowing that your righteousness is of him.
Yeah.
Amen. So praise God. We'll close with that. And I hope that blessed you. It blessed me. And remember, the joy of the Lord is your strength.
Amen.
And the joy is for us. Happiness is for us. It's good medicine. So, you know, hey, we don't have to go to, if you want medicine, open your Bibles and Dr. Jesus will give you all the medicine you can have.
Yeah.
But don't be sad. Don't be, you know, when you know the truth, it says it'll set you free.
Yeah.
Amen. So be glad, be joyful.
Yes.
Amen. We started off with this. Stay joyful.
Yeah.
Too many distractions coming your way. Too many sad news out there. Well, guess what? When you know the truth, you're going to stay joyful in Jesus' name. Amen.
Yes.
So, Father, we thank you for the opportunity to share your word, Father.
Yes.
I pray, Father, that
you'll
listen and obey what your word says, Father.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, before we close, we just give you the opportunity. If you never accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior,
mm-hmm.
now's the time.
Yes.
You know, this is the right time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so all you have to do is say, Lord, I've sinned against you. I repent. Come in my life. Be my Lord and Savior.
Yes.
And all you have to do is just go to a Bible-based church where you can go and start learning what the Word of God says
yes.
and read the Word.
Amen.
It's the truth that's going to set you free from all the mindsets, from
yes.
all the peoples and all the negative things
yes.
that are coming against you.
That's right.
Amen. And you're going to be joyful and you're going to be victorious and you're going to enjoy life instead of being
yes.
sad and doom and gloom, you know.
Yes.
So praise God. If you have any sickness in your body, by the Bible says that by Jesus Christ we're healed.
Yes.
This body is a temple of the Holy Spirit.
Yes, it is.
So we don't receive any sickness in this body, Lord. We just thank you. Those that are watching, those that are listening, We speak healing in their bodies, Father
yes.
God. Whatever it is, just put your hand on it.
Yes.
Wherever you're aching, wherever you're hurting, Lord, I thank you that by Jesus Christ, I am healed. Amen. From the crown of my head to the soles of my feet, those spirits of infirmity, sickness, disease have to go in Jesus' name. Don't bow to the name of Jesus. So we command them to go and we release and we believe and we receive our healing right now in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. So it's time to give. If you watch and listen, you'd like to give your tithes, your offerings, you still can. All you do is go to our website. It's on the screen, NBCBBA.com, and hit that donate button. If you're mailing it to us, NBC PO Box 252, Wampa, Texas, 79843. Amen. Just want to say God loves you and we love you.
Amen.
Praise God.
Praise God.